and you're going to call the babe that she carries Jesus. You're going to call him Emmanuel. Emmanuel means God with us. Now Joseph, he's just about as brave as Mary is, because men that were engaged to young girls, and they weren't treated real well either. They were going to be, both of them would be ostracized to the nth degree. But he takes her to be his wife. And he takes care of her through her pregnancy, making sure he doesn't harm her or the baby that she carries in any way, shape, or form. And then is with her to hold her hand when she has to. God's asking us this year to go through some things that are very common. He's asking some of us to realize that going forward is going to be a lot harder than it was a year ago. We're being asked to be the adult. I don't know about you. How many of you like to be adulted? I really don't want to be an adult. I'd really like to be a kid who could sit underneath the Christmas tree and hope for that special one. God didn't call me to do that. Just like God didn't call Mary to not do anything. God called Mary to bring the Lord of our world, our Christ, into our world. And Mary said, okay, make it be. Let it be as you say. And that's what he's calling us to do too today. You can get through anything with God. You can do anything with God, because remember, the angel told Mary, there is nothing impossible if God declares it to be. Nothing. So when we're feeling our lowest, and I know that some of you, today especially, is a hard day. Christmas is always, the holidays are always hard. Remember, you're not there alone. You're not walking through this alone. God is there with you, holding on to you, perhaps holding you up, perhaps holding the microphone on that didn't want to stay on. Perhaps, maybe, God is telling you it's going to be okay. Today is going to be okay. And you're going to make it through. And then he's going to walk with you whatever those days bring. Because I don't know about you, but there are lots of days that my eyes leak. And there's lots of days when if anybody looked at me, they would think, you know, that I was Rudolph because my nose is so big. But today I know I'm not alone. That God has walked with me through this whole year, and it's been a tough one, folks. When you lose a brother and two sisters in the same year, it's a real pain in the side. When you lose a wife, a mom and dad, no matter what age we are, when we lose our loved ones, it hurts. And our eyes will leak. I suspect that many times during Mary's pregnancy that her eyes leaked a whole lot. Lord, what have you got me doing now? Lord, what? Okay, if this is what you... And then she comes to the birth. Now, how many of you, I'm asking this other women, how many of you knew that you went to have your babies, what it was going to be like? Anyway, I sure didn't, but my nephew's wife had had a baby just before, about a month, in fact, it was a month to a day before I had my son. She said, just think you got a watermelon and you're going to put it out on the table. And it's going to come from a place that hurts. Okay. That's as much as I knew about what was going to happen. I think that's why God sent Mary to be with Elizabeth through those 3 months, so that she would know what that was going to be like. God has sent many of you ahead of us, those of us that are grieving today, to tell us, this is how it's done. This is what worked for me. Let me hold your hand and walk through this with you. You see, God sometimes has to use human beings to let us know that we're walking together with him. Don't ever forget that, folks. And know that on this Christmas Eve, you are surrounded by love and angels, and mostly by God, for you are God's children. Amen. Now, as I've said for the last several weeks, months, if you're going to give your offering to the family church, it's the best box on that side and a basket for pieces on that side. And for those of you who were at a charge conference the other night, it looked really, really good for us to be coming together this year, if that's at all possible. So that separation isn't going to have to happen. Charge was a blast. I got home and I said, I survived my last charge conference. Yes! God walked with me. And he gave me the best charge conference I could ever have with these leaders and many leaders that are out in our audience today, giving voice to the joys that our merging together has come. How we have loved one another. We have done things that we hadn't done in a long, long time. And we did this. And I think that's important for us to know. Please join me as we share in our prayer for our tithes and offerings. The God of abundance lays the bounty of all creation before us, strengthens us when we are weak, and fills us when we are hungry. Let us share deeply and joyfully, that all may come to the table of God's heavenly feast. God, O wise, accept these offerings, the fruit of our labor and efforts, in obedience of our faith through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. Thank you. come now to that time when we share our joys and our concerns. One thing I forgot to tell you at the beginning of the service, there's these pads in the pews, and they're there so that we can know who it was that was worshiping with us today. Please sign them and then make sure that they get back to the outside so that when Deb takes the count, that it matches with Dan's. Dan takes the count and then Deb takes the count. And then we figure we got mostly everybody covered. There was one other announcement, I can't remember what it was. It must have been real important, and I think it was. I know one thing we do need to remember. This is not the only Christmas Eve service issue. We're going to be having another one this afternoon or evening at 7 p.m. And the Freddie band is going to be leading that service. And I've had a chance to look at it, and it looks like it's going to be an awesome service. So if you're around at 7 o'clock tonight, please come and worship with the Freddie band. I will not be here tonight. So it's kind of one of those times when you get to worship God without the pastor. Come on in and worship. Now, as far as prayers go, today I would like to share that my sister Isabel is celebrating her 82nd birthday. She is the last of my siblings, and I am so proud of her that she made it to 82, first of all, but that it is her birthday. I also want to let you know that, and I'm sure that they probably don't want to know, but I'm going to do it anyway. Grace and Bill have been dealing with COVID. Bill had it really, really bad, and Grace's case was very mild. Bill's was bad enough that he had to go to the hospital and get IVs. I got a text from Grace that both are doing much better, that they're back on their feet and doing their thing. So. And Bill is eating. That was part of his problem. Bill was too sick to eat. And he's eating, and they're both gaining strength, and they wish you all a Merry Christmas. That much I can tell. They didn't know I was going to end their lives. Is there others that you would like to share? Our first year?
Yes. I have a joy, Pastor Freddie, that I would like to present to you. The gifts that your congregation has gathered and wish to present to you this fine morning. And I get to present it to you. So thank you for everything you do for us, and congratulations on
your final year.
My sister's traveling. She's in Virginia visiting her son. And she has shingles, so pray for her.
Which sister?
Norma.
Norma. Okay. Thank you all for the gift that you give to me. You don't know how much that means, so that's hard for the gift, but the love that you share, that you're willing to share your life. No, I'm good. I got put back here first, and then
just the joy to celebrate the magic of Christmas. I mean, I know that it can be difficult sometimes, but I mean, seeing Christmas through the eyes of your children is pretty incredible. So it's a very magical time of year. You just like to take the time to slow down and enjoy it.
It is good. Oh, by the way, did you notice? I can hear you today. I had the blessing from my hearing aids. My hearing aids aren't fixed yet. And he said, I can't have you having to use a translator, especially on Christmas Eve. So he turned around and he grabbed me a full pair of hearing aids. And he said, by the way, these are premium. But you're still going to get your own back. We're going to trade back. Okay, Ashley. Do you know, I haven't been able to hear women's voices and kids' voices in probably 4 or 5 years. On the way in that day, Elvin the Chipmunk came on. Do you know, I never knew he was saying words when he was singing. I heard every word he said, though I wish there wouldn't have.
Well, as you know, it's been a rough year for my family, but 21 years ago tonight, we surprised the church family by introducing my son, who we had brought home the day before and had kept a secret from most everybody because we had an adoption that had fallen through previous to that, so we didn't want to share. So, yeah, it was a great blessing to share him with all of you 21 years ago tonight.
29 years?
21. What? I'm sorry. So he just turned 21 on the 6th of December and became a daddy on the 8th. So we have a baby blessing for him and Savior. So.
Thanks, Dad. Parker passed away on Thursday.
So I just went for his first family because her family's going through a rough time right now.
What's Parker's last name again?
Wolfie. Wolf.
Wolf.
Wolf picked it up out of the Wolf family.
Oh, Wolf. Okay. Pat.
I'd like to thank everyone for their well wishes for our family. As we mourn the loss of my mom, it was wonderful that we were able to celebrate as a family last Sunday, and pictures were taken and jokes were said, and my sister and her husband brought my mom home to have her take a nap. Linda said, "Mom, you look really tired. Why don't you sit down and rest?" She closed her eyes, and that was all. So it was such a blessing that she didn't suffer and that she was with family.
Can you imagine the joy that she had as Jesus welcomed her home? She had just spent that day with her family, and if you saw pictures on Facebook, you saw a big grin across her face, the whole and. Her daughter took her home, and she passed shortly after that. So yes, we must keep the hero thing in our prayers also, as they have been. Many people are going to miss Joey.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, say them.
We had prayed for my friend Gigi, who was going in for testing for potential breast cancer. And it came back that it was just a cyst at this point, so she can go back in 6 months for another test just to ensure that it is nothing of note. So we're very thankful for that. And then also, you'll notice we have a plethora of treats for hospitality. Please feel free to take apples and pears home with you. I don't need that many at my house.
It's a Christmas miracle. We got apples and all sorts of stuff home. Please. Help yourself after the service. I don't see any other hands at this point. If I'm missing some, please tell me. My eyes are almost as bad as my ears. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, gracious and wonderful Counselor, God of all our days, we thank you. Thank you for the gifts you bring us here at Christmas time, for the joy of being a congregation that loves you so very much. We ask you, Lord, to be with those that we've mentioned as we think of Norma who's traveling and dealing with shingles. For them, we celebrated their son's 21st birthday, and also this year celebrated the brand new. We ask that you be with the Wolf family as they mourn the loss of Parker. But we also lift up the joy that Jeannie's thank you that you are helping Grace and Bill to both recover from COVID. COVID seems to be going around again. Grateful that they're getting better. Can we thank you, I thank you, for the gifts that this congregation brings to me. And thank you for Isabel, who is celebrating 82 years today. Lord God, all these things we bring to you when we lay at your feet, and we know that you hear our prayers. And we know because you have taught us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever.
You know, I can almost imagine next year when the new pastor comes in, because I did my last 6 months with you and my company. When you, the first time you clap for amen, or the first time that you do our the regular blessing that we do, the pastor's going to thank you. So, within your own comfort zone, let us pass the peace as we know that we do. God loves you, I love you, and that God died for you to do a lot of love. And now because we have heard the good word, we've felt the feelings of God in our midst. Let us go tell it out loud. Please stand. God in your heart, and remember, you're not alone. Ever. Go in peace and serve our Lord. Amen.